Saturated R134a vapor at 12 degrees Celsius is compressed by a refrigeration unit to 800 kilopascals. How much power is required to compress 1.6 kilograms per second of refrigerant with a compressor efficiency of 87%? Like always, try pausing here to solve this yourself before watching the solution. This is the second example for the isentropic efficiency main lecture. The link to that 8-minute lecture and all the other examples and lectures of the thermodynamics course are found in the description below. Since isentropic efficiency is defined as the necessary work input of an isentropic compressor over the necessary work input of the real compressor, as explained in the main lecture video, we can rearrange this expression to solve for the work of the real compressor. This means that we first need to calculate the work input for the isentropic case W.S. We know that that work is equal to the mass flow rate times the difference in specific enthalpy H2S minus H1. The mass flow rate we have, which means we have to find H1 and H2S. For H1, we have a saturated vapor and its temperature. This tells us that we can go to the saturated refrigerant tables by temperature and look up Hg, saturated vapor, for T1. That Hg would be H1. As for H2S, we can find the corresponding H2 for S2. And since we're finding the isentropic values, S2 is equal to S1. From that same table just now, S1 is Sg for temperature 1. This means that S2S is that value. With S2S and the pressure at the exit, P2, we can go to the superheated tables for P2 and look for S2S under the values of the column for S. Since S2S is between these two specific entropy values, H2S is between these two values. With those four numbers, we interpolate to find H2S. We substitute both specific enthalpy values to find the work input for the isentropic case, and with that work value and the isentropic efficiency, we find the work input for the real case. If you want to check out other examples for the isentropic efficiency topic, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below, where you'll also find the links to the other lectures of the thermodynamics course, as well as other engineering courses. Thanks for watching!